Today's video is about how doing your best always wins. Before I get started, I'm Tammy C. Walker. I'm a life coach, therapist, social worker. Have you been in a situation where you've done your best and you just feel so irritated because you know you put your all into it and you don't feel like the outcome is what you deserve? Let's just go with a job for an example. You go hard in the paint, you're at work every day, whatever your manager requests, you get it done, you're polite, you're professional, your vendors love you, the customers love you, raise time comes, you get a whopping 30-cent raise. I mean, is that a slap in the face or what? And you do this year after year. Even some years, they may say, sorry, we're not giving out raises today. How in the world does that make you feel? It makes you want to stop doing your best. I'm sure you probably have thoughts like, I should have did 50%. I'm not staying late anymore. And you know, you do want to have balance with these jobs. They will burn you out and stress you out. So always put yourself first, put your health first, put your family first, but always do your best at a job. You know why? It's energy that you're putting out. When you do good, God sees you. When you do good, you're setting your own self up for your own business. So you're doing good by working with someone else or under someone else. When you have your own business, you already have that work ethic. You'll already be a professional. You'll be driven. So it's not going to waste. Always give your best. And if that current employer does not appreciate you, you move on to some employer that does. Sometimes we have to, quote unquote, bide our time. You might stay at a job because your kids are in daycare. The job is by the daycare. You may be working on a business plan. You may be trying to sock away a retirement, 401k money, or the job could be just close to your home and it works for your schedule. But don't let anyone take advantage of you. If they want to keep giving you 30-cent raises and your supervisor isn't appreciating what you do, if it's a big enough company, move around, go to a new position. And if you feel like you're grossly underpaid, get the resume going and circulate it. Always keep a resume active anyway, because there could be a layoff or anything could happen. Number two, like, what if you're in a relationship and you really have been a great boyfriend? You really have been a great husband. You've been a great wife, a great girlfriend, and you get dumped, or they step out on you, or they don't appreciate you. They take you for granted. And you'll say to yourself, I knew I should have dumped him. I knew I should have got out of this relationship. I knew I shouldn't have put my heart on the line. Give it your all. Life cannot deny itself to someone who gives life its all. You don't want to shortchange someone in a relationship because they're not ready for you. Y'all hear me? Holla! You don't want to shortchange yourself in a relationship because someone is not ready for you. Sometimes we're in relationships where people, they just are not, I don't even want to say all that, on your level. Everybody is in a different time and space. And as I was thinking about what I wanted to say, I started thinking about childhood and being a therapist. Any of our trials, tribulations, trauma, and hurt comes from being that five-year-old little girl. Mama threw me in the closet. She didn't let me out. I was molested, God forbid. I was hungry. You know, I was a latchkey kid. I was bullied. All of this stuff comes up as a 30, 40, 50-year-old. I had to fend for myself. So sometimes in relationships, people act out as that five-year-old little boy or that six-year-old little girl. And I'm seeing some of these things happen, you know, in my own life. And it kind of helps a little because I'm not saying I give somebody a pass, but it makes me more sympathetic to others. So always show up as your best self. Even when it doesn't work out, you've given it your all. And this lines you up to be in a better, healthier relationship later, or you'll feel good about yourself. Women, women, women. I feel like I'm always picking on women in my videos. But I have to speak on this because I just hate to see some of this stuff that happens. And one thing about Tammy, Sharice Walker, that's me, the Virgo, like Beyonce, Michael Jackson, I can start naming all kinds of Virgos, Ludacris, Sanaa Lathan, Tyler Perry, Iyanna Von Zandt. Hey, I'm in good company. But one thing about us Virgos, We do not like our time wasted. We are perfectionists. So if I feel like somebody is blowing smoke up my butt or wasting my time, it just hurts me because I feel like I could have been doing something else. And it's double-sided because I was watching a video yesterday. He was like, I know you all say your time is never wasted. It's an experience. I feel like both sides. You know, I do say, oh, somebody wasted my time. But then, like the current situation I'm in, I did tell someone that you wasted my time. Did he really? I mean, I just have to be really honest. We had a beautiful relationship. Tennis, trips, sitting on the couch watching our favorite shows. He was the pallbearer at my mom's funeral. I didn't have my time wasted. I have like such beautiful memories with this person. I don't feel like that. I just wish maybe more was communicated to me. But even in all of this stuff that happened, I still feel positive over it because he's an amazing, freaking amazing person. So that's kind of what I'm leaning on now, and that's doing wonders for me. In the past, with some other guys, at times I could not muster that up because some of the relationship was not positive. It was negative, toxic, and a lot of drama. So that was not the case in this last one. So that's why I feel much more positive. But anyway, put your all out there. Do your best because it's energy coming back on you. So when I see my clients, meet my clients, I try to put my best foot out there. I don't get a second chance for a first impression. This is somebody's mental health. They're depressed. They're dealing with anxiety. They're grieving. They need me locked and loaded. They need me fully focused. So I really put my all on the line with my therapy work and with my life coaching because I feel like I'm really changing lives, or at least trying. So there is no room for error in the field of therapy. That's how I view it, and I'm very serious about it. Life will never, ever, ever, never deny itself to the man, to the woman, to the boy or girl that gives it his or her all. One thing about this, we are not responsible for how others treat us, but we are responsible for the energy we put out. You won't get what's coming to you, and what's coming to you is the very best. So put your best out, so you're going to get your best back in. Tammy Sharice Walker, you all know me. Thank you for watching. And again, I've been having a ball on YouTube. I just got a new group of subscribers, and I've been watching their channels. They are so amazing. I'm so excited about all of these people. So again, subscribe, hit like, tell me about your life. Do you give your best, and how has it paid off for you?